So here we go with the B part of chapter 1, measurement of length. First topic is list count. List count of an instrument is the smallest measurement that can be taken accurately with it. This definition you have to learn. The meaning of this topic is, when we measure something with the help of an instrument, what's the minimum value we can read accurately with the help of that instrument is called list count. I can explain you with the help of two examples. Let us see the example here. List count of a meter rule is the value of its one division, which is 1/10 of a centimeter. Listen, children, you all have seen meter rule. Meter rule means a ruler where the maximum length 1 meter we can measure with the help of it. 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. Within 1 centimeter, suppose 1 to 2 marking, if you see 1 to 2, there are total 10 divisions. 10 divisions means each division equal to 1 millimeter and 10 millimeter equal to 1 centimeter. Actually, list count reads the value of 1 division of that particular instrument. So, 1 division value of meter rule is 1 millimeter. So, list count of meter rule is 1 millimeter. Similarly, if it is asked what's the list count of a stopwatch, it will be given that there are 10 divisions between 0 to 5 marks. Like this it will be given. 10 divisions or 5 divisions or 20 divisions, like this it will be given. So how will you calculate? You will write 10 division equal to 5 second. Therefore 1 division equal to 5 by 10, that is 0.5 second. See, actually we are finding the value of 1 division. Here, ammeter. Ammeter is the instrument which measures the amount of current. Ammeter you can see in lab. It is used for measuring the current, how much current is flowing through a particular circuit. Here it is given, there are total 5 divisions between mark 0 and 1 ampere. So 5 division equal to 1 ampere, therefore 1 division equal to 1 by 5, 0.2 ampere. So 0.2 ampere is the list count of that ammeter. The next topic is list count of vernier or vernier constant. Question comes, define vernier constant. You have to write, the list count of vernier is equal to the difference between the values of one main scale division and one vernier scale division. This is the definition. If it comes, you have to write the statement. It can also be represented with the help of formula. So if definition asks, you won't write formula, you will write the statement. But formula we use to find out the list count. So formula you must remember. List count equal to value of one main scale division minus value of one vernier scale division. List count can also be written as list count equal to value of one main scale division divided by total number of division on vernier scale. Listen. If it is asked what's the least count of a vernier calipers, then you have to remember it is 0.1 millimeter or 0.01 centimeter. Now I'll show you the diagram of vernier calipers, and from where you can easily understand why the least count of vernier calipers is 0.1 millimeter or 0.01 centimeter. Open page 12. See this diagram. This is the diagram of a vernier calipers. Have a look, children. This part, main one, is called main scale, having total length 0 to 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter is the length of the main scale. Label diagram you must remember, because from here only you understand. This is a small one, black scale you can see here. This is called vernier scale, total division 10.
So main scale is having total 10 centimeter length, vernier scale total 10 divisions. Here is a screw which helps it to move, helps the vernier scale to move over the main scale. These are called inside jaws and these are called outside jaws. This part T is called the strip. It may also be asked to write the functions of different parts which I have shown you. Their functions you have to learn. Put a tick over here. Outside jaws, inside jaws, strip, main scale, vernier scale. Look at this. Outside jaws. Its function is to measure the length of a rod, diameter of a sphere, external diameter of a hollow sphere, cylinder. Inside jaws. To measure the internal diameter of a hollow cylinder or pipe. Strip. To measure the depth of a beaker or a bottle. Main scale. To measure length correct up to 1 millimeter. Vernier scale. Helps to measure length correct up to 0.1 millimeter. You have to buy her this all. It will be more clear when you will have the practical classes and you have to measure with the help of vernier calipers. Now we'll discuss regarding the zero error of vernier calipers. As you have seen here, J1 and J2 are the two outside jaws and these are the two inside jaws. With the help of this screw, you can bring both the jaws together when no object escaped between the jaws. Have a look for this diagram. When no object is there, with the help of the screw, when you put both the jaws together and you see on bringing the movable jaw J2 in contact with the fixed jaw J1, the zero mark of the vernier scale should coincide with the zero mark of the main scale. If it is so, the vernier scale is said to be free from zero error. Have a look. Zero of vernier and the zero of main, they are not coinciding. Coinciding means this point you will have zero mark. This zero mark will come along with this line. So it is not coming. If it comes, then it is called free from zero error. And if zero of vernier and the zero of main does not coincide, in that case, it will have zero error. There are two kinds of zero error, positive zero error and negative zero error. Have a look. On bringing the two jaws together, if zero mark of the vernier scale is on the right of zero mark of the main scale, that is this diagram, zero mark of vernier scale is right side of the zero mark of the main scale, then the zero is said to be positive. Zero error is said to be positive. This is the diagram for zero error. While operating your instrument, if you see it is happening, you have to decide your instrument is having positive zero error. Similarly, on bringing the two jaws together, if zero mark of the vernier scale is to the left of zero mark of the main scale, have a look, zero of the vernier scale is left of the zero of the main scale. This is called negative zero mark. Now I'll show you how to calculate positive zero error and negative zero error. For finding positive zero error, if this is the case, when no object is between J1 and J2, you will first check which marking of vernier scale is coinciding with any marking of main scale. Suppose 6. 6 marking exactly coming in line. Marking of main scale, marking of vernier scale coming exactly in one line. This is called coinciding division. So that we will note down. 6. Formula is plus sign, then this number into least count. So least count of vernier calipers is 0.01 centimeter. So we write plus 6 into 0.01 centimeter. So it is plus 0.06 centimeter. Similarly, if you identify it as negative zero error, please turn the page. 14. See negative zero error calculation. The formula is minus within bracket 10 minus the number which is coinciding. That is, in this case, it is 6. Close the bracket into least count. So here, 10 minus 6 is 4. With this negative sign, it is minus 4 into 0.01 centimeter. So, minus 0.04 centimeter. This is the negative zero error value for your instrument. If it is having negative, in that case, this way we calculate. Next class, I will teach you how can you find the correct reading when you have either positive zero error or negative zero error. Till then, you will by heart the definition of least count, what is zero error, kinds of zero error, definitions of positive zero error, negative zero error, and how to calculate. Thank you.